So this is a new segment that I've decided to actually create. Every Wednesday I want to create a new tutorial tip. I'm not going to make them overly long. I want to keep them really short and simple. What are we going to call this? Let's call it Wisdom Wednesdays. So this is my Wisdom Wednesdays tip. And in this tip this week, I wanted to touch on one of the things that it's happened to me in the past. In this one situation that I've had to, during COVID, I've had to shoot video in my conservatory. So my conservatory roof is see-through or clear, it's opaque. But the problem you sit with is when you're doing the video, the exposure changes due to the cloud cover going over with the sun. So you have this fluctuation of exposure from brightness to darkness, brightness to darkness, brightness to darkness. So there's two ways you can solve this. One way is the very long and monotonous way of going through each frame and then correcting your exposure correctly. And the second way is the way that I stumbled upon it. I did not know how to search for this. I found it, and then I saw that you could actually use this tool within After Effects called Color Stabilize, and this works really, really, really well. I cannot express to you how well it works, and it saves you a ton of times. But I found the solution. So we're in the office today, and I wanted to just walk you guys through this screen braced, and I'm going to make this really, really quick and simple, and hopefully this will make life easier for you guys. I'm going to use some footage of some green screen footage that I've shot in this situation to help, and I'm going to try and keep it really short and sweet. Right, so heading over to our excuse the machine whirring in the background. I have it rendering quite a bit of things in the background as well, so I do apologize for the whirring of the machine. Here we've got our timeline, and we've got our project. I'm just going to bring in some of this footage quickly. I'm just going to plonk it in here. I've created this project already, so we'll just quickly go here and we'll go new sequence from clip, so it keeps all the settings. And what I can show you here quickly when my machine catches up, not quite sure why it's lagging. You'll see as I scrub through this, you have the footage changing from brightness to lightness and then back to brightness. So in this, do we have change? We have some good change. So we've got some dark footage over here at the end, and then we have a light footage here at the beginning. So what you're going to have to use After Effects, and once again we'll use this replace with After Effects composition. Just right click on your clip, go replace with After Effects. After Effects will spring into life. So we're just going to create a new project. So here we go. So we've got our footage in After Effects now, so naturally you can scrub through and you'll be able to see all the issues that we're having with it. So like I said to you, this is a very easy solution. Go into your search over here and type in stabilizer, and you get color stabilizer. And then we just pop color stabilizer in. Don't worry, it will do this in the first time you put it on. All you need to do is tell what you want to look for. So you want brightness levels. So in this case, I want brightness. You naturally can change your levels and you can change your curves. We're going to focus on brightness. It asks you for a sample size. I always put my sample size to 5, and then I grab the little crosshair piece that you want, and I'm going to go and put it somewhere where I know it's going to be a consistent, there's not movement or anything like that, so that's a consistent spot over there. So then once you've done that, all you need to do is hit save. Go back to your Premiere Pro project, give it a couple of seconds while it works it out and gets everything there. And there we can see everything's now sorted. So our stabilizer. You can see me scrubbing through, and voila, you've saved yourself a lot of problems, a lot of heartache, a lot of issues in stabilizing your exposure. And that is as simple as it is. Naturally, render it out, and you know, hit your, you know, command save your project, and then if you want to just go over to render in and out, or render effects in and out. If you want to hit render effects in and out, you'll see that it all was through the clip. That was a very quick explanation on how to get your exposure leveled out if you've got multiple brightnesses happening within the footage that you've shot. And this can be applied to any footage, whether it's drone footage, time lapse, especially time lapse is a big one, because you'll have that exposure happening from, you know, day to night, or you know, cloud cover. So this really, really helps within the time lapses. So this is something I thought I wanted to share with you guys, that I thought would be invaluable for your workflow if you do have any problems. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, do me a favor, like, share, comment. It helps at the end of the day. And if there's any other specific tutorial that you want to see, I'm trying to keep these tutorials really short, really quick, and really simple. Well, thanks guys, until next week Wednesday. This is Wisdom Wednesday tutorial. I don't know if I'll stick with that. I'll give it a try. But anyway, have a good day further. Cheers guys, bye.